What's up, everybody? Chaos here, and today's COD History video is sponsored by Surfshark, which is an app and a browser extension that basically lets you place your laptop or phone anywhere in the world, and it lets you access the internet as if you were in that country. This is going to let you access and unblock websites and content that you may not usually be able to see. It also adds an extra layer of security when you're online. So how is this good for you, you may ask? Well, a lot of people are at home right now, and Surfshark, well, it lets you never run out of content. You can change your location, you can access and unlock a ton of different content on different apps, movies, shows, series, everything. And we live in a world where hacking is everywhere and public Wi-Fi is everywhere. Well, Surfshark has you covered. They will protect your public Wi-Fi connection, and it's the only VPN to offer one account to use on an unlimited number of devices. So here's the cool part, guys. Use code CHAOS to get 85% off plus 3 extra months for free of Surfshark. It also offers a 30-day money-back guarantee, so there is absolutely no risk to try it out yourself. The link is in the description. Check it out and get protected while you're online. I see a ton of you are watching and enjoying the content on the channel, but you're not subscribed. Take a second, hit that sub button, turn on those notifications, and let's get the Team Chaos subscriber percentage up into the 30s. Call of Duty usually has really, really good sound design. After all, they've got 8-figure budgets every year at least to get it right. They might as well go out, they go all out, and they make the sound as good as possible. I've seen it in person. The amount of work that goes into sound design for Call of Duty, you wouldn't imagine how much they go through to get it right. But when the game sounds so good, sometimes there are gun sounds that sound somewhat out of place or a little bizarre in comparison to everything else. What is up, everybody? Chaos here. Welcome to the channel. Welcome to the video. Today, we're going to be looking at some of the weirdest sounding guns in COD history. Not necessarily bad sounding guns, they just sounded off. Let me know which gun you think sounds the weirdest. Drop a like. Make sure you have those notifications turned on. Now, let's kick things off with the Reaver C86 in Black Ops 4. Now, this was a crossbow that was added to Black Ops 4 just a little into its life cycle because that game was jam-packed with DLC weapons. The Reaver was your standard crossbow, and it was actually pretty similar to the Black Ops 3 Shadow Claw, but the firing sound is where it differed. Rather than sounding like an arrow coming out of a launcher like we've heard in the past, it sounded like a whole bunch of metal getting shifted around every time you pulled the trigger. Now, all for this dinky little arrow to pop out of the crossbow. The sound was definitely a lot bigger than what you probably would be expecting from something like this, but that didn't take away from how powerful the gun actually was. A lot of people actually called it overpowered when it first launched because, well, it was. What's up with these modern COD games and adding overpowered DLC weapons post-launch? I wonder if there's a science behind that. Next up is the Level 8 or LV-8 Basilisk in Black Ops 3. Now, you're going to see a lot of Black Ops 3 guns on this list because the sound design, it was weird. Not bad, just weird. Black Ops 3 definitely had a unique sound compared to other COD games, and the LV-8 was, yes, another DLC assault rifle that had the fastest firing rate in the class, 1,000 rounds per minute, and it was overall one of the fastest firing guns in the entire game. However, that fire rate came with the trade-off of this long shot delay when you pulled the trigger. Once you hit fire, you have to wait about 0.3 seconds before the shot actually came out. Plus, because it was such a weird futuristic weapon, the firing sound was a little bit odd, kind of like a mix of what you'd expect from a ballistic and a laser weapon if they had a baby. Now, in practice, it wasn't that good of a gun because of that shot delay, but it was a pretty cool idea, and I commend Treyarch for trying something new. At number 8, the MX Garand in Black Ops 3. Now, the M1 Garand was on our most iconic firearm sounds in history COD video, yeah. And it's appeared in almost every COD game we've ever seen. One of those appearances was in the form of the MX Garand, which was a futuristic version in Black Ops 3, like the others. This version was a semi-automatic rifle that had to use every shot it had before being reloaded. And when you fired that last bullet, you got that beautiful ping before loading another clip. But the firing sound of the MX Garand was, it was weird. It was, I don't know, it was all, the Garand was always a thunderous gun in COD. But the MX version was very high-pitched, almost like the audio clip of the gunshot got cut in half during the editing of it. I mean, it's a pretty fun gun to use. I mean, it had that going for it, but it was just off when it comes to that iconic sound. Next up is the KN57 in Black Ops 4. Now, I can't be the only one on this video who thought this gun sounded weird. The KN57 was one of the most popular guns in Black Ops 4, and it bore a lot of resemblance to the KN44 from Black Ops 3, which was also very popular. But am I the only one, raise your hand, who thought the gun sounded like a bunch of farts in a bag? I mean, it sounded like a laser gun rather than a ballistic one. It sounded kind of like Squidward walking around in SpongeBob. I don't know how to explain it. I can't put my finger on why the gun sounded so weird, but you heard it. I mean, tell me if I'm wrong. It sounded weird, did it not? Maybe it didn't sound like Squidward, but it definitely didn't sound like your normal assault rifle. At number 6, and you're lucky I didn't put it at number 1, and for all of you Cheekum, whatever lovers, get over it, all right? The Cheekum CQB in Black Ops 2, also known as the Fart Cannon. I don't know if I dubbed it that, but somebody did. It was a 3-round burst submachine gun in Black Ops 2 that I hated. And I know, there's a weird fan club that follows it. I know, I see them in my comments every time I say something bad about it. In terms of stats, it was pretty mediocre. It hit for between 33 and 18 damage, meaning it was impossible to get a one burst kill without headshots, which is lame for a burst weapon. But the reason why people liked it was the fire rate. The burst would come out of the gun at 1,250 rounds per minute, and there was no, zero burst delay. So if you had the timing right, you could spray away. But for people like me, I preferred to take the Scorpion Evo, which also fired at 1,250 rounds per minute, but was fully automatic. Plus, the Scorpion didn't sound like someone farting over and over again every time you squeezed the trigger. At number 5, the Helix or HLX-4 in Black Ops 3. This was basically the SMG counterpart to the LV-8. The HLX was another extremely fast-firing gun, but with a long shot delay when you pulled the trigger. So even though you would be firing at 1,000 rounds per minute and killing in 4 to 6 shots, not bad, you would also be waiting about a half a second before those shots actually started downrange, which was pretty lame. And if you got killed, well, actually, you got killed quite a bit from it, I'm sure. I'm sure you know it, but Call of Duty involves a lot of mid-range tagging on people and tap firing. And when you have a gun that literally can't do that, well, it kind of makes it an all-or-nothing gun. You either run up and dump the entire mag into someone, or you don't fire at all because of the shot delay. And that's why a lot of people didn't really care for either of these guns in Black Ops 3. And it sounded weird. At number 4, the Bar in World at War. Now, this was one of the few machine guns in World at War, and it was pretty powerful. It would hit between 35 and 45 damage without stopping power, but unfortunately only fired at 375 rounds per minute, so that could get in the way quite a bit. But if you played the game back in the day, you know the bar actually sounded pretty weird. It was extremely metallic and crunchy. Yeah, metallic and crunchy, almost like the gun was broken. I mean, like, if you heard your gun making this sound, you would think there was a part loose somewhere inside of it internally or something, but no, that's just how the gun sounds. World at War had some awesome sound design, but I would say the bar was definitely one of the weirdest. Once again, weird doesn't necessarily mean bad, so keep that in mind. Back to Black Ops 3, the L4 Siege. Now, this was one of the DLC launchers in Black Ops 3, and while it wasn't all that special in terms of stats, it was actually, the sound was crazy. The Siege would carry 4 rockets at once and rapid fire them instead of the other single fire launchers in the game. But the trade-off was reduced damage. So when you weighed out the pros and cons, it really wasn't all that worth taking with you. But it was the sound was something. The Siege had a high-pitched metallic firing sound, and it made it sound super unique. A lot of the guns in Black Ops 3 were pretty high-pitched in comparison to other CODs, which some people are critical of that because it made them feel like they had less punch than before. But then, there were the exceptions, like the L4 Siege, which proved how high-pitched guns could still sound awesome when you squeeze the trigger. At number 2, the Stinger in World War 2. This was one of the DLC weapons in COD World War 2. It was an LMG that would hit for 40 to 50 damage per shot, but it only fired at 312 rounds per minute, making it one of the slowest firing automatic guns in COD history. Now, you didn't see it a whole lot on the battlefield because of how slow it was. But if you did see it, you would definitely recognize the sound. You didn't even have to see it because it was weird. You would know the sound. The sound of each shot was long, weirdly long. Not like other COD guns where the audio for each shot kind of stops when the next shot comes out, if you know what I'm saying. It made us sound like there was this weird echo with the gun. Plus, the sound itself was this huge metallic crack thundering across the map, which was cool, but it also didn't fit super well in a game like COD World War II, where they were trying to go for at least a little bit of realism, maybe? And at number one today, the P06 and Black Ops 3. I remember when Black Ops 3 first came out, everybody was talking about this gun. A three-round burst sniper rifle. What? The P06 was one of the deadliest guns in the entire game, but it was extremely hard to use effectively. So, you really had to know what you were doing. It would hit for a flat 90 damage, and that burst would come out at a ridiculous 1,818 rounds per minute, which is dumb. But because of how long the shot delay was, the overall fire rate was somewhere around 225 rounds per minute. But when you pulled the trigger and got that little charge up and then the three shots came out, you heard something like nobody had ever heard in a COD game. It was another gun. It kind of sounded like it was both a laser weapon and a ballistic weapon at the same time. And that mixed with its power made for some very unique gun sounds that a lot of snipers absolutely loved, but a lot of other snipers hated because they couldn't get the hang of it. So you guys tell me, did you like the P06 or did you stick with the more traditional snipers in Black Ops 3? There you have it. Those are some of the weirdest, not worst, weirdest sounding, well, besides the Cheekum, weirdest sounding guns in COD history. If you guys enjoyed, drop a like, and I'll see you soon.